नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, आर्ट एंड टैरो में आपका स्वागत है। जब हम थॉट्स की बात करते हैं, हम बात करते हैं इंटेलेक्ट की, माइंड की, थॉट्स की, न्यू आइडियाज़ की, विजन की। ये सब क्वालिटीज़ जो हैं इस थॉट में आती हैं। आज जिस कार्ड के बारे में हम बात करने वाले हैं वो कार्ड जो है थॉट का सबसे पहला कार्ड है, विच इज़ कॉल्ड द एस ऑफ थॉट। मेरे देखे थॉट इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग ऑफ ऑल द सूट्स। अक्सर जो है लोग जो हैं इवन टैरो रीडर्स के अंदर जो है ये आइडिया होता है कि भी जो शॉर्ट्स हैं दिस इज़ नॉट रियली अ वेरी पॉजिटिव सूट, एंड जो बाकी के सूट्स हैं एज कम्पेयर टू दी कप्स, दी वॉन्ड्स, दी पेंटिकल्स, वो उसको ज़्यादा पॉजिटिव मानते हैं एज कम्पेयर टू शॉर्ट को। बट मेरे देखे शॉर्ट भी कम नहीं है। शॉर्ट इज़ समथिंग with which you can actually have a lot of clarity in your life and you can have a beautiful life just because of having a sword in your life. Not having this sword in your life, your life will be a mess. So this element of sword is somewhat it is needed with the combination of cups, with the combination of pentacles, or with the combination of wands. No matter what you choose, this has to be there. Because this is what is needed for the balance. Ace of Swords के बारे में बात करने से पहले हम इसके keywords में जाएंगे। Ace of Swords के keywords होंगे breakthrough, new ideas, mental clarity, success, mindful, vision and strong intellect. So this card predicts victory against any obstacle. This is what the power of the sword is. So once you have this power, you can actually achieve anything. बहुत सारे लोग जो हैं इसको इस तरह से इंटरप्रेट करते हैं इन टर्म्स ऑफ वॉर, इन टर्म्स ऑफ यू नो डेथ, बट आई डोंट सी दैट सम इन एनी वे लाइक दिस हैज एनीथिंग टू डू विद इट। इन फैक्ट ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द swords, इट हैज़ नथिंग टू डू विद एनीथिंग यू नो विच takes you towards death. In fact, it is more talking about what is happening in your life. It is more talking about your mental activity which is happening inside. So जब हम ace of swords की बात करते हैं, ace of swords में हम देखते हैं कि एक हाथ जो बादलों से बाहर आ रहा है और जिसने एक sword पकड़ी हुई है और वो sword जो है वो pierce कर रही है crown को। crown के एक तरफ जो है एक symbol है victory का और दूसरी तरफ सिंबल है पीस का। तो इसको थोड़ा सा ध्यान देने वाली बात है। अक्सर हम इसको इस तरह से देखते हैं कि दैट दिस इज़ जस्ट यू नो विक्ट्री सिंबल एंड सॉर्ड, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सॉर्ड्स यू हैव एक्चुअली वॉन ऑन समवन एंड बट इस पीस के एलिमेंट के होने की वजह से सब कुछ चेंज हो जाता है। दिस विक्ट्री इज़ नॉट बेस्ड ऑन फोर्स और एग्रेशन or anything negative, it is based on a very positive note. That is why the symbol of peace is also shown. Jo hum six flames dekhte hain, that is more of a symbol of purity and divine energy. To kisi bhi cheez mein jo hai, jo agar agar hum fire ka symbol dekhen aur iske andar jo fire hai wo bahut hi ek beautiful way se jo hai signify kiya gaya hai, kya gaya hai, और यहाँ पे जो है फायर जो सिग्निफाई कर रही है वो क्लैरिटी के लिए कर रही है, एक डिवाइन प्रेजेंस के लिए कर रही है। सो द सॉर्ड इज पियर्सिंग थ्रू द क्राउन विच इंडिकेट्स दैट देर इज़ नो ऑब्स्टिकल फॉर क्लियर थॉट्स एंड इंटेलेक्ट बिकॉज अ शार्प माइंड इट रूल्स ओवर एवरीवन इवन द किंग। क्यों? Why is that? Why does the sword can even pierce the king? Why does the sword even can win over the king? For the simple reason is because it stands for truth. It stands for authority. So once you have the truth, then even the king will bow down to you. That's what the power of sword is. So having this ace of sword in your life, it's like having a lot of clarity inside you. It's like having a pure vision. तो जब हम इसको देखते हैं, sword की अपनी ताकत बहुत है। Sword is like complete in itself that it can win over anything. But SWOT का purpose कोई जीतना नहीं है. SWOT का purpose जो है एक ऐसे agreement पे आना जिसके अंदर जो है एक win-win situation create हो, एक ऐसी situation create हो जहाँ पे जो है सभी खुश हों. तो अगर सिर्फ SWOT को use करेंगे तो there is dissatisfaction. But because there is a element of peace which is also there and the victory is based more on that, so it basically shows that the victory is achieved on the basis of peace. So in this situation everyone walks away satisfied. It is a gift of mind, the glorious splendid human mind. To ye jo haath jo hai, it's none less than, you know, like the God is offering you this gift of intellect here, and this gift is nothing but a pure intellect, a pure mind, a splendid and glorious human mind. That is what is shown in the King of Swords, and that is also signifying the clarity where the Buddha reached. Hum Buddh ko bolte hain, Buddha unko Buddhatva prapt hua. Buddhatva ka sirf simply jo meaning hai wo hai enlightenment, and enlightenment comes from intellect. So this sword is such a pure symbol when it comes to enlightenment. अब अगर हम background में देखेंगे तो there is a kind of a very barren kind of a background which is shown. तो अक्सर जो है ज़्यादातर एक ही thought आएगा. It's like something which is very dry, not juicy, nothing is there, nothing beautiful is there. But let me tell you, there is also beauty in the desert. There is also beauty when there is nothing around. When there is like just clarity, just pure empty space which is there. The Zen religion is actually based on that. Zen is a form of Buddhism which started from India. The Buddhism which started from India, when it reached Japan, it became Zen. And Zen is just based on pure clarity. Nothing, no bullshit, no mess, nothing. And there the system of enlightenment is such that it is based on sheer intellect, that the disciple needs to be at a peak of clarity, and for them the enlightenment just happens just like that. So it's not a gradual process. When it comes to Zen, it is just sudden. It's like a sword, the sword which cuts to anything. And finally the Ace of Sword, iska ek bahut hi ek beautiful ek spiritual jo meaning nikalta hai wo ye ki kyunki hum iske andar jo hai upar there is a crown which is shown, and this crown basically is also representing the crown chakra of the human mind, of the human body. Crown chakra means the sahasrar. That simply means that we are talking about the enlightenment here. So Ace of Sword is a pure form or a pure symbol of enlightenment in itself. It's a very beautiful card, and I want everyone to have this clarity about this card, because there are many stupid notions about this card. Lots and lots of people, you know, they don't really know what it is, you know. So one just need to understand that sword is also part of us. This is not something which is a negative card. This is something, a very positive card too. And when it comes to life, we have to accept all the suits. Everything is needed to make you complete. Everything is needed for the journey. Remember, when we talk about the fool is the one who started this journey with all these four suits in his bag: the sword, the pentacles, the wands, and the cups. All four were needed. If it was not needed, then God would have not given him, and the fool would have not started his journey. So just remember that the Ace of Sword is a blessing. When it comes to your reading, it just tells us that you are at a stage where you are blessed with clarity, and you can see clearly, and you can take a good decision. And this is also known as the card of yes. This is what the Ace of Swords is. So this was my reading for you for Ace of Swords. I hope you enjoyed it. I will see you in my next video. Till then, stay happy, stay blessed. Namaste.